Hi everyone, and welcome back to Total Coins. So, in today's video, we're going to be doing another £2 coin hunt. We've got a bag of £500 in £2 coins that we're going to be going through, looking to try and fill those last three slots in our album. But before we get to the album, just wanted to say you don't want to forget to enter my 1,000 subscriber giveaway. I'll stick a link up to the video in the top corner. But we've got six prizes that we're giving away, and that means there'll be six winners. So don't forget to head over. The entries for the giveaway will end tomorrow night, so don't miss out. And obviously the winners will be drawn on Sunday. So with that said, let's have a look at what we are still missing. So two Commonwealths left to get. We've got Northern Ireland and Scotland. We are missing the Mary Rose. And other than that, we have got everything, including our really good conditioned Shakespeares that we ended up with, were they last week, I think? So, just three coins left to get. Obviously, we don't know about any of the 2020 coins, but as soon as we find out, we will get something added to the album. But before we get started opening the bag, obviously we can see that this bag was put together on the 16th of March 2020. So it'll be quite interesting to see what is in there. So what we'll do is we'll do the first bag in real time. And we'll go through what we're looking for. So the first one we've got there is Technologies. We don't look to keep any of them, just because all of the years are sort of quite highly minted. I mean, there's only one year where there's about sort of 3 million produced. And there's our first commemorative. So it is Wireless Transmissions. And the second biometallic commemorative £2 coin to be released. It is a common one, but still a nice one to find to get us started. Other than that, sort of really like to sort of find something for the book. It's been a while, but that is going to be the end of the first bag. So what we'll do now is we'll speed up until we find something interesting. And there we go, straight off the bat, we have a DNA double helix. I really, really like this design. It has been one of my favorites. But once again, it is a common one. And we start that bag off with a Brunel's portrait. So part of a two coin set, you've got this one and you've got Brunel's achievements. Very, very nice design. Next up, we've got Charles Dickens. So another really nice design. But once again, it is a common one. And there we go. We've got the steam locomotive. Another really nice design. But once again, another common one. And we have Rugby. So Rugby was the first biometallic commemorative £2 coin. And with this one, you can actually find a slight error on the edge as well. So you'll see there. So it says Rugby World Cup 1999. But sometimes the one isn't quite struck properly. So it'll end up being World Cup 999. So, only a small error, but nice one to look out for. And we've got another DNA double helix. And we've got our first one above face value. So it is a Magna Carta. Very nice. So with the Magna Carta as well, there is a slight error that you can find with this as well. And what you'll find is just between the person on the left and the throne, you'll find an extra bit of metal. So a little cut error that's sort of out there in circulation. I managed to find one. Didn't realise it until sort of a lot after I found it. But going back through my spares, I was able to find it. So definitely one worth keeping an eye out for. And to start that bag off, we've got a gunpowder plot. So one that we see quite often. Obviously with this one, there is also a slight strike error on a lot of the rims. So you'll see there, it says Premember instead of Remember. And the Royal Mint have admitted that that is an error. But that one's quite strange actually, because all of the R's, apart from that one, just there, are all missing the kicker. So I might put that one to one side actually. I don't think I've had one where all of the, let's see if November, no, so that's got the kicker. So yeah, that's a bit of a different one. And next one up we've got is Charles Darwin, or the man as the animal, the man and the animal, as some people have called it, naming no names. Yeah, not one that we see too often, but it is a common one. Very nice. And we've got a Roger Burns. So we had some luck with this one last time we found one, where it actually had sort of an off-center error. Very nice. That is one that's above face value as well. We've got another Charles Dickens, not in as good condition as the other one. and a Florence Nightingale. So for some reason I'm not overly keen on this design. Not one of my favourite £2, but a bit of a variation for today's hunt is good. We've got our first VE day of the hunt. I think this one is still the highest minted commemorative £2 coin. So we do tend to find it on most hunts, but it is very, very common. We've got another Brunel's portrait. Not seen the arches yet, so or Brunel's achievements, which is quite surprising. We've got another steam locomotive. That one's in a lot better condition than the first one we found. Very nice. We've got a Trinity House. So not one to see too often. It is a nice design as well. Very nice. And the next one's looking like something actually. No, it's not, it's just the technologies. There we go, we've got another VE day. That one's a bit grotty, but other than that, it was looking in good condition actually. And to start that bag off, we've got an Act of Union. We managed to find an absolutely stunning condition one of these a little while back. That is the one that we've currently got in the book. And we've got another Charles Darwin. So that's two for the hunt. Not one that we normally find, so that's quite good. and we've got the First World War centenary. Another really, really nice design. I would admit the war-centric £2 coins have all got really, really nice designs on them. They're all quite common, bar the Navy centenary. But definitely like those designs. We've got another Brunel's portrait. And I can already see that the next one is going to be something. See if you can guess from the side. Any ideas? So, shall we have a look? And it is London Underground Train. Very nice. It was one that took me absolutely ages to find, and once I found one, I then started to find loads of them. Loads in a relative meaning, but really like that one. And we've got another Charles Darwin. So that has been free for the hunt. That is absolutely brilliant. But that is going to conclude our second to last bag, and we'll do the last bag in real time. So it has been an absolutely brilliant hunt. We've got a couple above face value, and there we go, right at the end we managed to find a Brunel's achievements. Absolutely brilliant. So we've got the Brunel set, but other than that, it has been a really good hunt. And that is going to be it for the last bag. So star pull for today, do you know what, I've got to give it to the Underground Train. I absolutely love the Underground set. I'd say it's my favorite. Probably just a bit above Shakespeare's actually as well. So yes, definitely like that one. So that is going to be the end of today's hunt. As I said at the beginning of the video, don't forget to check out my 1,000 subscriber giveaway. The link will be down in the description below. You can also check me out on social media. My links will be also be in the description down below to Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And yeah, with that said, thanks for watching. Really hope you enjoyed today's hunt, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one. All right, bye.